two old friends, Arabian somehow, yet more ancient, sit in a palace far older than themselves, set on a mountainside surrounded by vineyards, date palms, and citrus orchards. Insomniac and affable, they pass the long starry hours preceding dawn in the smoking of hashish and the propounding of riddles. "Share my pleasure at this puzzle and its resolution," said the darker to the older, and he passed his hand across his companion's eyes. The older man then stood in the dream and watched the puzzle, a world of form and law, interlocking wheels and passion and intellect unfold. He passed into its species and empires, dynastic families and individual persons of genius, philosophers and catastrophes. He felt the texture and tone of all the being in the world his friend had created. He sought the secret pattern his friend, he knew, had surely hidden in his creation, for this was a game that they often played. Finally, in a great despotism, in an age of brash science and bright decadence, he saw himself divided into the persons of two brothers. Through time, through their wanderings and lifetimes which passed before him in a moment, he perceived the intricate and pleasing nature of the riddle. Understanding, he dissolved the mists and wheels of the dream fable with a laugh. A laugh they shared. God, whatever it is throwing a gigantic shadow over human history now, because now the creode of development that leads to our merging with this thing, the walls are very steep, the water is moving very swiftly, and it's almost as though the future event is throwing off great sparks that are themselves faceted, contradictory epitomizations of this mystery. This is what Mohammed and Christ and Buddha are. They are human personalities that were situated in time in such a way that they became macrocosmic reflections of the superordinate endemic humanity that is going to be generated at the end of history. And we are close to be a being in time, is to share in the immense flood of precognitive anticipation that fills the universe in anticipation of this event. And that's what being is, and that's why it's so rich and so complete within itself, and yet always somehow pointing beyond itself.
that has been anticipated since we were herding our cattle across the plains of Africa is now upon us. The east is streaked with the blood of rosy dawn. It is coming upon us. Suddenly, it's just boundaries and agony and crushing pressure. That's where we are. And we are going to have to shed history like a snake sheds its skin. All of magical humanity is awaiting us and cheering us on, lending their weight. They're all out there, you know, Proclus and Plotinus, Plato and Hypatia. They're all pulling for us. And every shaman and shamaness, every magician, practitioner, as far back in time as you go, was part of the plan, the conjuration, the great work, the distillation of the quintessence.
The first two goes didn't seem to do anything, but then I took a really big hit.
You're getting a giggle on this.